What's up, everybody? Lance Hedrick here, and today we're going to talk about puck preparation. I like this topic really deep in that two-part espresso series, but I didn't really get deep into it because I wanted this to be bigger videos. I'll go ahead and start with the first person to see that above. But today we're going to talk about specifically the Weiss distribution technique, or WDT. What is the Weiss distribution technique? Well, it's essentially a technique where you're taking some sort of rod and needles or whatever it might be, and you're going through and trying to declump and fluffen up the bed. So I've seen people do this with toothpicks. In fact, the first time I saw it personally was in 2016 at a place in Chattanooga, Tennessee. Someone had a toothpick beside the grinder and would declump using the toothpick. Now, I've done research, and I've seen apparently people have been doing it since at least 2006 on the home barista forums, and they were using, essentially chopsticks and really big toothpicks. I don't know why they thought that was a good idea. Anyway, the goal of doing it now, with what we have learned, especially with the decent espresso machine community has learned through watching the puck resistance and understanding extraction, through the technology that the machine affords, is that there are better ways and worse ways to do WDT. Is taking a toothpick and poking around WDT? It is technically. Is it good WDT? That one is decent. Actually, no, it's not good. Ideally, what you're going to want are needles, like acupuncture needles, that sit around 0.25 to 0.4 millimeters in diameter. Anything really over 0.5 millimeters is going to effectively compress some of those grounds in your puck. And what's going to happen with that? Hello, Harborview. So, what I have here are my two favorite tools. This one has 0.4 millimeter acupuncture needles in it, and there are what, nine needles? Yeah, nine needles, I think that. Eight on the outside and one in the middle, and it's at an angle. And then this one, they're pretty much straight, and they're 0.22. Now, I use these for two different reasons. I like to do deep WDT with this, and then I like to groom the top with this. Now, let me just quickly, I've been going fast. Let me go over the different ways that people have been doing WDT. There's essentially three that I've seen personally that I think are kind of the most practiced. The first would be deep WDT, which is taking your tool and going all the way to the bottom of that basket and coming all the way out, and you're totally raking through that entire basket with your tool. The other one I've seen is shallow WDT. You may have seen this on Scott Rowell's Instagram, which I'll try to find a post and link in the caption below. But the way that he does it is he grinds into his sport filter at all different angles, and then he just barely puts the tool into the top of the bed and does some circular motions to level out that top part. And then you have what is called puck raking, which John Buckman from the Deep WDT machines, what he does, he uses maybe three or four needles, his preference is 0.4 millimeters, and he will grind straight into his portafilter. He actually uses a niche, which I have here. He just grinds straight into the portafilter, allows it to get a mound, then he takes his tool, which I think you can buy from them, and he just scrapes the mound till it's level, all right? So the idea is you don't want these needles to be big enough where it's moving the ground everywhere. You effectively want it to slice through it and fluff it up, right? So I'm going to show you how I do the WDT, and I'll also show you puck raking and shallow WDT. So let's get to that. I'm about to grind this coffee, and I wanted to make one thing clear. To do this, I highly recommend getting some sort of shock collar. I'm using the decent one because it is magnetic and fits onto your portafilter. But you want to do this because when you're fluffing it up, it tends to overflow the basket. So I would highly recommend getting this if you're going to lose a lot of grams. You can get this one, there are plenty on Amazon for $5 or so. All right, so I'm going to grind into my portafilter. All right, so historically, what people would do after grinding into the portafilter is they would finger distribute and then tamp, or they would tap and tamp. Both, I understand where they're coming from, but we have seen objectively through many tests that have been performed over the years that those are not the most effective WDT, in fact, is when done properly, all right? So there are dangers with doing deep WDT. If you don't do it well, you're going to have a lot of channels that are going to occur. If you do it well, it actually has a higher extraction than both shallow and puck raking. So I'm going to first show you deep WDT, and I like to use my 0.4 millimeters for this. And it'll look like this from the front angle, and we'll do overhead in a second. I'm going to go in. I'll go all the way down to the bottom, essentially, all right? And yes, people are going to say, doesn't that scrape the basket? It does, but there's cosmetic defects that won't affect the functionality of your basket. If that's something that stresses you out, if you have a good enough grinder, feel free to do the shallow or the puff raking. But if you have a grinder that does tend to produce clumps, I recommend deep. And even if you don't, deep has been shown to do a couple of tenths of a percent higher of extraction. May not mean that much. But anyway, here it goes. I go all the way to the bottom, and I start out quite aggressive because I WDT for about 10, 15 seconds. And then I'm going to make more shallow, circular motions while I'm clockwise turning the WDT. And I'm slowly raising to hit all layers. And now I'm at the top, and then what I like to kind of do is just barely rake it. But when you have 0.4, it's a little too thick to make it really nice and smooth. So what I like to do is I switch to my 0.22 to finish it off, to make it nice and glossy. Now, this arguably isn't really doing very much for me, but I like the way it looks. Makes me feel better about the shot. So I'm going to do it. Makes it look really pretty. All right. Now, when it's done, I take it off. And as you see, it's still a little bit above the rim, even though this dose fits the basket. So I'm going to take the size. I'm going to do a gentle, which this is back talking from what I said in my espresso videos, and I'll explain that in a second. I'm going to gently just pop it down like so. So I gave it a gentle but firm tap, holding the head so my hand accepts the vibrations. But now we have it kind of settled down. Now I'm going to do my tamp. And boom. We've tamped it, and our puff is beautiful. All right. So that would be what Deep WDT is. I hope that makes sense. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my WDT tool, and I'm just going to re-fluff up the bed, which you can do if you have thin enough needles. If you have toothpicks or a fork, or some of these other do-it-yourself ones I've seen, you're not going to be able to fluff it all the way back up, which shows you that it's not doing the job that you're wanting it to do. So if you can effectively go through the toothpick and make a tamp puck fully fluffy again without any clumps, then okay, you proved me wrong. But I'm telling you, outside of above about 0.5 millimeters, you're not going to be able to do it. So I'm going to take this, I'm putting it into the puck, I'm going to slowly start to turn it up. Just boom, boom, boom. I'm going to start by just kind of poking at it because it's pretty dense when I tamp it. Now I'm just... Let me put this card back on. I'm already making a mess. Now I'm just going to fluff it all the way back up. And we are at full fluffage. I know you can't see it. I'm about to show you that it's over the edge again. It's just as fluffy as it was before. So check this out. Boom. We're back to full fluff. All right? So now I'm going to do my final grooming bit with my 0.22. Always sound effects. Oh, so now we're back to full force. Now I'm going to show you what shallow WDT will look like. Essentially, what you're doing with the shallow, and I actually like using thinner, even thinner needles for the shallow, but you're barely putting it in, and you're doing the same thing. You're kind of just spinning. You're just kind of spinning. And I would recommend this if you are grinding straight into your quarter filter and rotating, right? So this is a great way to do that. If you have a good grinder like an itch or something else that's pretty clump-free, just grind straight into your portafilter, do the shallow WDT where you're essentially doing what I do deep, but just up at the top layer, and then settle those grounds, and you're good to tamp. Now, the final one is puff raking, and for this, I'm going to have to grind some more so that you can see what it looks like in front, but we'll do that. So just let it grind straight into the portafilter. I don't really worry about what's going on. Just straight into it. Boom. And then I'm going to kind of show you what it looks like. So we have that mound in the middle. All right. And in fact, I'll just leave this color off to show you. Then I'm just going to take the 0.22, and I'm just going to rake it. We're raking it around. Obviously, you want a color on. But I'm just raking it to the areas where there's divots. Just kind of raking it around. And you want to keep doing it until it's nice and flat. Make sure those clumps are out. And then you can check yourself if you do a really flat level tap. You can kind of expose if you're higher or deeper in certain areas. You can go back in and you can kind of fix it before you can. But that's the idea of puff raking. Boom. And then you take the tamper and you tamp. Right? So there is puff raking. So those are kind of the three most observed ways of doing the Weiss distribution technique. I know I've said that word so many times, and you're like, dude, shut up, it's so annoying. Set on me, how else am I supposed to refer to it? So that's WDT. Like I said, I tend to always do the deep WDT, which is going deep, doing circles in a circle, like so, and then slowly coming up, right, until I'm at the top. And I kind of just smooth it out. I prefer using the smaller, thinner diameters for that top layer. To the deep, though, I do like 0.4. I recommend between 0.3, probably 0.3 to 0.4 is great for deep. For the shallow, I like, you know, this is 0.22 up to about 0.3. But yeah, so you have deep, you have shallow, and you have puck raking. Hope that makes sense. I highly recommend you getting a WDT tool. You don't have to buy one of the $40, $50 ones. You can buy some acupuncture needles online. Very easy, just put Google search. And then there are people who have been publishing 3D designs of these. You can go find one, download it. If you have a 3D printer at a local library, go print yourself off one of these. This is actually 3D printed. So go get you one of these. Or you can drill holes in a line cork, buy the acupuncture needles. The ends are more than big enough to take a drill bit. So drill some holes in a wine cork, pop it in there, but this will, especially if you have a clumpy grinder, you'll see noticeable improvements in your extraction right off the bat. So anyway, this is another length video. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed, please give that little thumbs up a tap, and a little subscribe. Hit that button, that red button that says subscribe. That'll be awesome. Maybe the bell for notifications, you know, maybe we can go. That was my video on WDT. Check out my other videos on ESPRESSO. We're doing a lot of those. If you've got those, we're just chugging along. Thank you so much. I hope your flow flows magically, and throwing a lot here. See you.